Welcome to this podcast.
Boogity, boogity, boogity! Let's go racing, boys!
You should have gone to bed. What's up? How was your first day back after... What, were you on vacation for like 3 weeks?
Yeah, something like that. It felt like it towards the end.
No,
it was fine. I mean, just of course, just going back through emails, making sure nothing got overlooked or missed or whatever, you know.
Just playing some catch up.
Yeah, so that was probably the majority of the morning. And then, of course, getting back into trying to sell some websites and make some contacts and all those good things.
So. You sound tired. Hi, Molnix.
I am, man.
What's going on?
I am. I'm tired.
It's good to be back.
Excited. It's exciting to be back live here. We haven't done this for, what, a week now?
A week.
I got to shake my head, man. I get to see myself. Look, when my head's down, I feel like you can, like, see this, like, balding area. I'm not quite sure what it is.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, but I'm not balding. Like, in 15 seconds, I can grow my hair out. This is, like, a week and a half, 2 weeks of growth. Like,
I've always thought that you shaved your hair because of the balding, because that spot's always been noticeable to me.
Yeah, that's what I don't get, is it looks like I have, like, this huge balding pattern, but my hair's thick as all hell, so I don't know. I don't know why. No, I shaved my head because I hate combing hair. There's nothing in the world I despise more than having to comb my hair.
Dude, I don't comb my hair.
Yeah, well, your hair is pretty. Like, my hair's thick.
It's like I get it cut short, and the only thing I do in the morning is I take some gel or some paste and run through there and do my little poop, and I'm done.
Out of the shower and
literally just how I do my hair is this. I go boop, 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 and I'm done.
See, that's too much work.
Too much work.
All I do is run a towel across it. Like right now, it takes more because I have to just leave it all nappy and crappy like this. How about you, Molnix? What are you reading that's more important than us?
Nothing. I was making sure my phone was turned off.
You can leave your phone on. This ain't no high class thing.
That's every single meeting I'm on with Andy is just down like this. And they're like, hey, Andy, what do you think about that?
You got to be careful with that because Molnix will call you out. Like, I'll be sitting there doing something, and all of a sudden he'll ask me a question. I'm like, come on, man. I got you on this call with me so I don't have to answer questions.
I didn't think that was a thing until he asked me if I did it on purpose. And I'm like, no, actually, I didn't even know you weren't paying attention.
Yeah. So, and it's not that I'm not paying attention. I hear stuff, but if it's not relevant to me, it's irrelevant. So, but I had a buddy that used to do that all the time. We'd be on conference calls together. And when it was just a wait, you know how you get on some of these calls that are just an absolute waste of time. Not that we have that with any of our clients, but you know, sometimes you're on waste of time calls. And he, like, right in the middle would just be like, well, Andy, what's your opinion on this? And I'm like, dude, like, we're 15 minutes into a call. I checked out 7 minutes ago. Like, this is a no-brainer, you know, especially because we do marketing. So a big portion of what we do is spending time with people trying to sell us stuff, right? Like, here's why you should sponsor my TV show or my race car or my whatever. And a lot of those you just kind of check out after a period of time, you know? So, but yeah, that's why we used to have to, that used to happen to me all the time. And Molnix pulled that crap on me on a call last week, 2 weeks ago, maybe. We're just sitting there going along. And so it depends on where I'm at, but like right here, my camera's on this screen. So usually when I'm talking to people and doing stuff, when you see me over here looking this direction, I'm working on something. Like, I'm already done. I'm checked out. And so when that happens now, I got to be real careful because Molnix will be like, what do you think? I'm like, oh, I see how this is going to be now. I got you, game. We're good.
Now that I know, I'm going to make sure I do it more often.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, Ray, what was the highlight of your – what were you gone? Seriously, you were gone from Friday to Sunday?
Yeah, I left Friday and then came back this past – so I left Friday before and then came back this past Saturday. I got a bad echo for some reason anyway. So we went down –
it's probably our sound checks.
It probably is. I don't know why. It just started. Like, I don't know why. But
yep,
it just
I hear it.
So, really? Yeah, are you guys, it's probably you.
Is that me? Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
No echo from you.
Is it echoing from me?
No, not at all.
Are you echoing from yourself?
I don't see how I can be. Let me tell you.
I don't hear any echoes.
Hold on 1 second. Let me
this is that. A good section of the show. This is this is. We should just call our show Three Stooges.
Here's a flower for your hat, madam.
I can't hear you now.
You can't hear me?
Well, I can, but you don't sound as good.
Really? Because I went to my daggone mic, and not, but I'm still getting feedback. Let's see here.
At least we're not live yet. Yeah. Oh, no, wait. We are.
We're recording. It's all good.
This is just the part where Madison's like, son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch. Why are they?
You sounded better when you weren't. Like, now you sound like you're, I don't know.
How's that?
Is that a daggum brand mic, or is that the brand of the mic, the daggum?
The daggum mic?
Yeah.
Is that better?
I don't like that daggum mic.
All right. Is that better?
No, that's worse.
Really? Yeah.
It should be can't better. You just go back to what
you
were
hear
doing
me
before?
Better here? Is it,
yeah.
Do I need to get closer to the mic?
Is yeah, you got to be right. You got to be right up on it like this.
I got to be eating it. See, this is a.
Condition. Andy, where's your mic?
I don't have a mic.
What the?
I'm using the camera mic. That's probably why the sound sounds
podcast. If you don't have a
well,
mic.
Well, that's what I was using. I was using my the. I unhooked.
My mic has a light.
Yeah, mine doesn't. I've got a
sound. I feel like I want a mic now. I can't even do radio voices with this built-in onboard mic.
See, and that, I've got a like I can't hear myself, so I can't do a sound check. Like if I could hear myself, I've got a board over there that I could adjust my highs and lows and everything.
When I listen to our podcast on the internet or on wherever you get a podcast from, however this works, whatever, it shows up in my little podcast thingy.
Yeah, yeah.
When I listen to it, it's very obvious to me that we don't spend a lot of time doing sound checks. Like the fact that we even have a board that adjusts it is pretty amazing to me.
Well, it doesn't adjust your guys; it just adjusts mine. So I don't have a powered mic. I've got to have a powered board for my mic to work.
Well, this is like $40, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And I got this one so I can mic drop it.
Mic drop.
Like if I ever want to, I just be like, boom.
Why would you want to do that?
I don't know. It's part of the power.
But anyway,
there, Madison, so, can you build a whole show out of this segment?
Oh, she will. So we went down to Florida, went to Disney World, went to Discovery Cove and Universal, and then the Friday before we went to Clearwater. Andy, I asked you, but you and Molnix, you've heard of Winter down at Clearwater, the what Dolphin's Tale is the movie. Have you ever seen that movie? Dolphin's Tale. So we went.
Hang on. How, like, oh yeah? Like, oh yeah. Like you definitely know that movie, or you're just going along with the story moments?
It was a pretty big deal when it first came out.
Yeah.
How did I miss this whole thing? Like, I had heard of a dolphin that had this, but like.
Andy, you don't watch many movies, though.
That's true.
Okay. But it doesn't sound. Okay, so let's go on with
your
the story.
Wife
and then I'll try
Jordan
to figure out.
All about it.
I'm just trying to figure out. Okay, Amanda and Delaney, I would expect, but Andy Molnix and Ray Page, not two of the guys I would have pictured watching a movie about a dolphin.
Well, I have three daughters
that
watch movies all the time, and I watch movies with them because I'm a good father.
Molnix, how come you know about it?
Because I watch all movies. It doesn't matter.
I like watching a bunch of movies too. Like
every movie, if I pick up into it, like, you know, 5 minutes into it, I'm compelled to watch the balance of the movie.
Pretty much.
Okay, so let's tell everybody about Winter.
Well,
it had Morgan Freeman in it, right?
Yep, Morgan Freeman was the doctor that designed the prosthetic for Winter.
Yeah. Okay, I know what movie you're talking about.
Yeah.
You guys are.
There was actually two of them. There's Dolphin's Tale and then a Dolphin's Tale 2.
I did not see the sequel.
Yeah, you got to watch the sequel. The sequel gives you a little more background because dolphins, of course, are pod creatures, right? They like companionship. Well, so Winter, so Clearwater Marine Rescue, their main objective is to rescue, rehabilitate, and reintroduce animals back into their environment, right? Well, it's really wasn't ever designed to be an aquarium or where you can go to originally to go and just see, like, a North Carolina aquarium, you go to the aquarium down at the coast and there's this, like, I don't know how many thousands of gallons tanks got sharks and everything else in it that are, you know, it looks like you're on the bottom of the ocean at a submarine wreck and there's all this, you know, marine life floating around. Well, this place wasn't ever designed like that. So they rescued this dolphin. It was caught up in fishing nets, and it did some pretty good damage to the tail. Where they brought it back, tried to rehabilitate it, tried to repair the tail. It wouldn't repair, so she ended up losing her tail. Well, she learned how to swim without the tail. But what it was doing, instead of going up and down like this, she was going sideways like this, and it was damaging her vertebrae to the point that she was going to die. So this kid was just like really liked animals, got all into it, and it's based on a true story. The movie is. So he got kind of attached to the dolphin, and him and his mom and the guy that owned and the Clearwater rescue place was actually getting ready to, the guy that owned the property or owned the place was actually getting ready to sell it, to tear it down to build condos or something like that. I can't remember exactly what it was, but he was getting ready to do away with it. So it was a big thing, you know, they had to raise money and all this kind of stuff. But through this whole process, basically, they designed a prosthetic for this dolphin to be able to swim properly so she could constantly live. Now, she doesn't wear it all the time. And honestly, I'm not sure if she wears it much now.
Does the dolphin still live there?
Oh, yeah. The dolphin's 15 years old now.
It's sort of like How to Train Your Dragon. They built a prosthetic so that guy could fly his dragon.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. And Andy hasn't seen that movie either.
He hasn't seen that one either.
No.
You got to start watching movies, Andy.
I don't. Watching, I just don't think I would be watching.
All right, here's a good exercise. All right, Andy,
yeah.
Top five comedies of all time. Go.
Animal House, Caddyshack. Oh, boy. I don't know. I'd have to, top five of all times. I'm trying to think of what other ones come to mind quick. But those two for sure.
Those are good.
Yeah, like a Happy Gilmore's got to be in there.
Okay.
I'm trying to think of. You ever seen Spies Like Us? One of the greatest movies ever made. Like,
yeah, that's
just
one.
Hilarious.
Steve Martin in it?
No.
It's got Chevy Chase and then.
Dan Aykroyd. You know, one of my other weird favorite movies. Well, like Waiting was a great movie, but like. I loved Major Payne. I think that was one of the funniest movies ever made. Like, so I don't know, but there's five. So
you're missing the National Lampoons, though.
Yeah. I mean, how can you not have Christmas Vacation? But that's
Christmas Vacation.
Yeah, for
so
sure.
Good.
The original.
The only thing is you don't ever think of Christmas Vacation until Christmas time, and then you're like, oh shit, this is the greatest movie ever made.
That's
The Great Outdoors.
The Great Outdoors.
Suck My Wake, the name of that boat.
Yeah.
The Blues Brothers.
Guys, if you see him running, Great Outdoors is just
Big Bear. Awesome. Big Bear. Big Bear Chase.
Big Bear. Chase! Big Bear Chase!
What is he saying?
What? Big Bear Chase me!
Big Bear Chase.
What other movies did I miss?
Holy Grail. Monty Python, Never seen Holy it. Grail. Oh, yeah. Just classic.
Ah, blow my nose at you, so-called Arthur King. You and all your silly English kniggets.
And Something About Mary, the only reason I'm putting that in there because Something About Mary was the pivoting point in comedies. That crossed all kinds of boundaries in subject matter and slapstick comedy. So I think Something About Mary is an honorable mention just because of what it did for comedies after they produced that movie.
I can't think of the name of it, but what's the movie? I think it's called The Bride's. I can't think of Andre the Giant's in it.
Princess Bride.
Yeah, Princess Bride. Yeah.
So I don't think of that for some reason.
Okay, let me ask you this right quick. I'm sure you have, Monix, but you watched Napoleon Dynamite, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever watched Napoleon Dynamite, Andy?
I've tried like four times. But each time I just want to
smash that movie into a brilliant. I think
it is.
Oh my god!
So here's the thing with that movie, and this is what I tell everybody: the first time I watched that movie, if you would ask me, I told you I wasted an hour and a half or 2 hours of my life. It was the stupidest movie I've ever seen in my life, right? But I think it was because I was going in it looking a plot, looking a story. You know,
really, you were going into it expecting to be entertained, and you weren't.
Well, but then I don't know why, but I watched it again, and it's the most hilarious movie you ever seen in your life.
It's not.
It is because I went into it then. I went into it then thinking this thing is crap. There's no story. There's no this. But then you start picking up on the little nuances of it, and it's freaking hilarious.
It is.
Oh, it's
when Uncle Rico sidearms the steak at Napoleon and knocks him off his bike. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that.
No. Dude, I mean, and you got Kip. How can you not? I mean.
So that sounds like I haven't seen it, so I don't know it. But that sounds like, I mean, how can you get any better than that? You think about the zit scene or any of the scenes from Animal House where he's peering in the windows.
Oh, they're great.
Napoleon
Dynamite is
if you're even considering putting Napoleon Dynamite in the same realm as A Christmas Vacation in an Animal House, that's just.
But you also told me that
it's not
Letterkenny was the stupidest thing you ever watched. Like the first time I showed it to you, and then
Letterkenny is funny.
And then you binge watched it. You do the first time I showed it to you in Talladega last year, and you're like, I can't watch this stupid shit.
It was. Stupid.
And then all of a sudden, like I call you up one night, and I'm like, what are you doing? And you're like, watching Letterkenny. It's just hilarious.
There's parts. Exactly. So there's like in Letterkenny, there's parts of it that are absolutely hilarious, and there's parts that are just dry and suck. Like in Letterkenny, the hockey player guys, like I don't find them funny at all. Like
you
I can just eliminate them. No, I.
Shorzy?
Like Queasy and Wheezy or Shorzy, whatever. Like they just.
You don't like Shorzy?
No.
Oh
no, it's just
God.
Stupid to me because it's the same. It's like the Family Guy where they do the same thing over and over and over. Like when he hurts his knee and he's like, ow, 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 for like 5 minutes. Like I did. The hockey guys are probably my least favorite part of Letterkenny. The rest of it, hilarious.
Yeah.
Like I can listen to those guys sit around the fruit stand or the vegetable stand for the whole show. Like that's all they need to do.
Yeah.
It's hilarious. I can't put Napoleon Dynamite into a category with any of that stuff. It's
horrible. I heard you say you've tried to watch it four times.
I've tried to watch it probably 50.
Well, you need to go ahead and just bear down and watch it.
I can't.
Just bear down.
No.
It's
just not good.
Some of Will Ferrell's movies are like that for me. Like Talladega Nights. I couldn't hardly stomach that movie when it first came out, but the more I watched it, there was some gold that came out of that movie. Like,
well,
don't put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby.
Yeah. Or you start adding in like old school. I mean, how do you not think of that movie?
You're my boy, Blue.
Oh,
yeah.
Old school.
Frank the Tank, baby.
Frank the Tank. That was a great one. But I don't know how we got on to that. How did we get on to that from my vacation? So we go to Discovery Cove. That's where they have, that's where Molly and the girls like swim with the dolphins and all that good stuff. You know, me being a cheap bastard, I was like, I don't need to swim with dolphins. I scuba dive. I've swam with them out in the big water. And now it's like they're out there riding, you know, holding on to the dolphin, getting pulled around, and I have regrets. I should have paid for the deal and went right. But, so the crazy thing though is like my brother and sister-in-law had already done it. So we're standing on the beach like taking pictures and video, and my brother-in-law is like, he's like, yep, now you get ready to speaking to my brother-in-law, I had a live studio audience last week when we were recording the podcast.
Remember that?
He was sitting beside me. He thoroughly enjoyed our podcast, by the way. But so he's like, yep, he's like, now you're gonna get to go there and spend $250 on pictures. I was like, I took all the pictures I need right here, you know, and I'm talking all big and bad how I'm not going in there spending $250 on pictures for this, that, the other. Well, then, you know, I realized once we walked in and they started showing the pictures and I heard all the, oh, that's so cute. Yeah, we got some really nice, nice pictures.
Who's behind you?
Mackenzie, she's over there digging in a drawer.
What's she doing?
Trying to find
the untangling wires?
Dude, I'm telling you what, I don't know if it's here, bring that over here. I don't know if it's teenage daughters or whatever, but I can't keep chargers in this house, phone chargers. The blocks, you can't find those. You can't find cables. I mean,
so you can't just grab something and not talk about it.
Kenzie brought it to me, so this is from the.
Oh,
yeah.
That's a good picture, though.
It's a great picture. It came with this nice frame here.
Swim, so swam, swum?
Swim, swam, swum, and then they got this beautiful Discovery Cove, Orlando. They do not sponsor the podcast, by the way.
Heck yeah.
Photo album where, you know, it's got several of the different photos in there. And
can you lip grab a dolphin?
Lip grab? No, that's Kate swimming.
Oh, it's a whole book.
Oh, yeah, it's got it's got getting kissed by the dolphin.
Oh, dude, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. That's the memories.
On the dolphin. You know, yeah. It was good times, man.
Does it have a picture of your half neoprene shirt?
My half what?
Your half neoprene shirt.
Oh, no, yeah. Who told you about the half neoprene?
You did.
That's right. We did the podcast on Monday. Yeah, it didn't happen. But it was pretty cool. And then they had this whole area where it's like a fake reef and stuff. And they had stingrays that were 4 foot, 5 foot wide. Big tang. It was really cool. So then we did that. And then Monday, of course, we went to Hollywood Studios, which I got to go into Star Wars land, which was the greatest thing ever.
Well, did you get your saber?
No, dude, I failed as a father, right? So we were talking about it before we were going, and the girl's like, you know, Caitlin likes Star Wars, but, you know, nothing that I thought we were going to want to build lightsabers with, you know. So I'm thinking, whatever. Well, come to find out, she really wanted to build a lightsaber. Well,
I did. 10 minutes on the podcast.
Oh, absolutely, I would have. But again, being a cheap bastard, $170 to build a lightsaber, but they were sweet. So I was going to take Caitlin to build a lightsaber, but you had to have reservations, and come to find out, you can't make reservations the night before. You got to do that shit 3 months in advance to get reservations. So I tried the biggest ride there is called the Ride of the Resistance, or Rise of the Resistance, which is pretty, pretty cool. So basically it starts off, you're a rebel trainee, right? So they're transporting you to a rebel base to be trained. Well, you get captured by the Empire on your journey. Andy, are you familiar with Star Wars? So you totally don't know what when I'm talking, you have no clue.
I saw the first ones. When they started remaking it, I was out.
Yeah, well, so, but you get caught by the Empire and brought onto their ship. Well, the way they do this thing is amazing, because it's like you walk in this one area, and then the next thing you know, when they open the doors, it looks like you're in this totally different thing, but you're coming out. I mean, it's just really cool. So they open the doors and you're on the Empire ship, and you've got these Empire soldiers get over there, you rebel scum, and just talking crap to you, and you're going in for interrogation, and they put you in this chamber that you have to go in, and they're going to interrogate you. Well, as they're, you know, Kylo Ren comes in and is talking to you, trying to find out where the rebel base is. You know, of course, all of a sudden here comes some lasers and stuff, and they start fighting. So the rebels come in to save you. And you cannot see a door, you can't see anything. All of a sudden you see the red glow of a lightsaber cutting the door out, and it just opens up and comes out. And then you get in this little thing and come in, but it's really cool. Well, to get on that, you have to do it they put you in groups, and then you have, at 7 o'clock in the morning, you have to get on and register to try to get on the first flight, or you have to wait till at 1 o'clock to try to get on. It's really hard to get on. When it turns 7 o'clock, you've got to click join the virtual queue, and if you hesitate at all, you're done. It's booked up. It's crazy. But so when we did it, our group, we got it, but my brother-in-law's family didn't, right? So they were going to have to wait to 1 o'clock, which wasn't a big deal, but we kind of all wanted to ride together. So, of course, we get into the park with Elizabeth's disability and stuff. We have to go in and, you know, get a special pass so you don't have to stand in lines and all that good stuff. And so we did that. Well, while I'm sitting there talking to the lady, I'm like, well, let me see if I can work some magic. So, of course, I go into salesman's mode. Hey, look, I'm here with my family and my brother-in-law's family, and I don't know what happened, why we didn't all get on it, da, da, da. We ended up getting on it, so all of us got there. Well, then I was trying to do the same stuff with the whole, because Kate really wanted to do the lightsaber deal. So I tried every trick in the book. I even pulled an Andy. I didn't even tell Molly this, but I offered the guy at the line $100.
Hell yeah.
In there. And he's like, man, I can't. He said, it'll cost me my job faster than anything else I can do.
That'd be my first go-to. Yeah. Hey.
I tried every trick because
I ain't gonna wait this line anymore if you like.
I tried every trick I could come up with and didn't, and no success there. So I failed as a father at that. But the rest of the week was really good. Of course, went to Magic Kingdom, rode those rides. I mean,
should have carried a ladder.
A ladder.
There's a guy that gets into every place, and if you carry a ladder with you, they think
you
just walk by everybody.
Yeah, just get a service shirt and a ladder.
Just walk right by. But no, it was good. And then of course, like I said, we went and saw Winter and all that good stuff and Clearwater. But other than the traffic, so we go down. It's like an hour and a half ride from Orlando to Clearwater. It took us about 1:45 to get there. And then on the way back, it kept saying it was going to be like 3 hours. And I'm like, what the? So I'm looking, you know, we're riding this, that, the other, and I'm driving, and Molly's on the phone. And she's like, yeah. She's like, as we get in, we got 15 minutes away from the condo we were staying at, and it took me an hour to go 15 miles. I was about to lose my shit. I can do a lot of stuff, but traffic like that, and then people get stupid. And, you know, if people were just courteous and not trying, you know, it irritates me more than anything in the world is 2 miles back, there's a merge over sign because the left lane is going to end. Well, if people would start merging and people would be decent human beings, you wouldn't have traffic jams, right? But no, you got assholes that have to fly up and then try to get in. Well, by that time, everybody else is super pissed. And you're like, you're not getting in.
That's why you ride with me and you become anti-asshole. So what you do is you just block that left lane. And, like, yeah. I put people in the grass. I do all kinds of shit. If I'm in my truck, my Audi, doesn't matter. I can't do anything. But if I'm in my truck, I just get right next to a semi and just lock them up. And then I just sit there and roll next to that semi. And then everybody's diving in behind you. And so be it. But then all of a sudden you start moving. But that's where you get semis like the other. So I used to always be on a CB, and we'd do it all the time. But that's what you got to do is you got to block that lane.
Well, so coming back, say, like going down there, my kids are getting ready to feed the dog, so you're going to hear a lot of damn noise. So
we're a family.
Yeah. So on the way down to Florida, no traffic issues. Went right on. I mean, of course you hit. Jacksonville, Daytona area, and you're going to have a little bit, but nothing major, right? So no big deal. Family got to go to Bucky's for the first time. Molly was giving me shit about how it wasn't the greatest in the world on the way down there, but then on the way back, she kept saying Bucky's. But on the way back, you know, of course, we stopped and got breakfast and all that good stuff, and everything was great.
Oh, he just turned his light off. No,
my TV for some reason keeps flickering. So I've got the most ghetto office in the world. I got my MacBook here. I actually have a 27-inch computer screen here, and then I got a 32-inch TV in the middle. And for some reason, the 32-inch TV just keeps.
Are they feeding the dog one piece at a time or what?
They're trying to be really, really quiet is what they're doing.
Yeah. I'm like, man, when I feed my dog, it's 2 scoops. I can feed my dog in about 4 seconds. This is going on a minute.
Kenzie's over there trying to be extra, extra quiet, you know. So that's why it's taking so long. But so on the way back Saturday.
I bet that dog.
Yeah, so it's about 9.5, 10-hour trip, right? Took us 13. We did stop and eat at Buffalo Wild Wings, but there was a couple times we got in some serious traffic. And one of those, like, it was the both lanes were just blocked up. Well, the car started going on the outside, the median, passing everybody, and I did what you did. I kind of edged over so they couldn't get by me.
Heck yeah.
And there was a couple of them that still did go around. We went into the grass and all that good stuff, so. I just can't stand it, but other than that, it was a good time, man. It was just, you know, it's like, you know how it is, though. You take a vacation, you come back, you need another vacation to get over the vacation, you know, mm-hmm. stuff like that.
Feel that.
So, yep.
Now what are they doing back there? Wrapping the presents?
That's the dogs actually eating.
Oh, seriously? Yeah. Goodness gracious.
Yeah.
I can hear them, boy.
Well, you got a herd. I mean, you know, I got like five dogs, the four here. My Dachshund's still down at doggy camp with my mother-in-law. So,
Jabers.
Yeah, good. It's good times. Good times. Well, so what did you boys do last week while I was out on vacation?
Worked. Quack, 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 quack. Well, Nick, anything interesting in your life?
No.
I wish you'd just point the camera at the dogs. I want to see what the hell is going on over there.
It's a fiend.
Oh, he muted himself for these own F-bombs. he's muted himself out right now. He's like, these guys ain't going to talk shit on me. I'll just go on mute.
It's a bunch of.
I mean, I'll leave it on if you want to hear my dogs eat. I mean, and usually they're done by now because they inhale this shit, but they must be trying to be quiet too, I guess.
They're going to town on it. Anyway, Molnix, what did you say now? What did you do last week?
Oh, I had to deal with a crazy tree guy and went up. This guy was trying to, I don't know, he was out of money or something, and he was supposed to be cutting some trees for me, and then ended up not wanting to finish, and now he's back in the game, and I don't know. I had an eventful Saturday, but nothing compared to what Ray was, you know, with the traffic and, you know, the dogs eating, putting a bunch of lead shot in some tin pans.
What it sounds like.
Yeah. And just stirring it around. Like, I don't even think he has a dog. I think his kids are just in the background going like this.
So I have an English bulldog. And if you've ever seen an English bulldog eat, I mean, they have to put their whole face down into the bottom of the bowl and chase the food around.
So that's exactly what it sounds like.
That's exactly what she's doing. Yeah. You know, because they can't, like, they can't just reach down and grab a little bit and come up and eat. They're rooting the whole time like a dog.
Why don't you just do TikToks of your dog eating? You'd be TikTok famous then.
It probably.
That'd be the key.
Yeah,
Japers. Probably. Yeah, it's pretty uneventful. Well, let's talk racing.
So, well, hold on a second. So,
okay, let's not
talk one of the last times I was there, Monex, you were getting some work done to the bike. Did you get that done and all?
Yeah, actually, I did. I got put a whole cam chest in, and it dynoed out at 107. So, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
And my gas mileage went down quite a bit. I'm getting between 28 and 32. I mean, if I'm doing 70, I'm getting about 28. If I'm 60 or under, I'm getting about 32. But I'm telling you, it pulls hard all the way through.
What cam chest you end up going with?
It was a full S&S cam chest.
S&S, okay, that one. Yep. Okay, yeah. So we used either the S&S or the fueling, and S&S, it becomes a guzzler. The fueling stuff, it has a pretty good wide band on it, but you didn't lose as much fuel mileage on it.
I think now I'm concerned about compensator integrity, so I might upgrade to a Baker compensator coming up.
I was going
to
say Baker. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They got a nice one. And you need to look at your clutch basket too. Have they talked to you? What now? Is yours a 107 or a 103?
107.
107. So the clutch baskets are known to actually, this because they had to make the clutch plates much bigger. They had to reduce the size of the basket. So those baskets are known for cracking. And if they crack enough, then, of course, you start getting slippage and it'll tear some stuff up. I think it's Baker makes it, and then Assault, too. They make a nice aluminum alloy replacement in there. It's lighter, too, so it reduces your centrifugal weight. Gets you
more.
Yeah, so it's good stuff.
Yeah, this fall I might have them throw in a Baker. I talked to my mechanic about the gear set with the increased horsepower, because the new six speeds are notorious for shucking third gear. And so I don't know. I was looking at a Baker grudge box just as a point of starting. But
super nice, man. You'll be good with it. I mean, unless you go crazy on it, that Baker grudge box will be fine.
Yeah, and I don't beat on it. I mean, it's. Yeah. I ride pretty easy, but now that Andy's eyes have glossed over.
Oh no! This section of the podcast brought to you by Nobody Gives a Shit.
I would say one of the only reasons I did that because I knew
I have to start.
So I knew Andy was going to be like fucking Harleys.
So I'm good. I'm actually, while you guys are doing that, I'm going through all my silicone rings here. So I'll just see like what to change out, you know.
So why did you not pay attention, and then you could look at be this. Interested in it?
Look at this shirt, and then look at this ring. Like,
did
come
you
on.
Buy it that much?
Look at that.
Yeah.
That is impressive. So annoying if I had one like that.
I mean,
that.
You do that and don't have to worry about it.
I'm scared of needles.
That's different. I'm scared of shots, but tattoos is no big deal.
Yeah, anyway. I got the silicone.
Yeah. I have six of them in here.
Truthfully, the only reason I got that is because I thought I'd lost my ring one time, and I knew if I had, Molly was going to kill me, so I knew if I had put that on my finger, then it would be kind of a concession thing. You know.
Because so. I actually did. If you lose that, it's like, oh, yeah. Yeah. Like, oh, sorry, Madison, there's a beep. Sorry. Three beeps, Madison.
Yeah.
And that's like from old school. Right, like earmuffs. You don't
earmuffs.
You abuse
earmuffs.
It.
That's what we need. That's what we need to do. Is that Madison earmuffs?
Madison earmuffs. That's perfect. Anytime we swear now, we'll just say earmuffs. That way, earmuffs. Madison can just maybe there's a way she can search for that.
Yeah, earmuffs. Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure she can. Pretty sure. If she can, I'll be disappointed.
All right, I feel like I gotta add an editor's note here. Unfortunately, I'm sorry to disappoint Ray, but I am not able to search anything on audio. Every time that you have a bleep here, that is me finding it. So sorry in advance for if I miss any more.
That was
all right. What are we talking about now that we're done with that Harley thing? Was that Harley stuff we were just talking about?
Why don't you want a Harley? You need a motorcycle.
I have zero desire to ever own a motorcycle ever. I've never ridden one and never will.
Nothing more free than being on a motorcycle rolling down the road.
Bullshit.
That's for sure. Absolutely.
How is that? Then okay, absolutely. Then I feel free when I ride a bike. I got a golf cart.
You got to pedal that damn thing.
I have three different electric bikes. I don't have to pedal anything.
Yeah, but you can't. Yeah, it's totally different. Totally
nope,
different.
I disagree. Yep. How can you tell me there's nothing more freeing?
How can you? I've ridden a motor. I've ridden electric.
Have you jumped out of a plane?
I have jumped off a building.
Why would you jump off a building?
Because I've jumped off a chair. Because of the stratosphere in Vegas, I'd do it. And somebody told me I'll jump out of a plane, though. I want to jump out of a plane one day.
That's absolutely insane to me. Yeah. Why anyone would jump out. But to my point is, no, like, everybody's different, and I have zero desire to ride a motorcycle. Yeah. Zero. Yeah.
Kenzie told me she'd rather have a motorcycle than a car when she turned 16.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. She doesn't live in Iowa.
Andy Molnix lives
well,
in
let's
Iowa.
See how well Molnix will have a race. I'll take my friggin' big four-wheel drive truck, and Molnix can ride his motorcycle, and we'll see who gets around more in the winter.
In the winter, I mean.
So I'm saying we live in Iowa. There's no purpose to have one here.
I ride in the winter.
I've already got 2,500 miles on this oil change that I did a month ago.
Nice.
Is that good?
That's a rider. Yeah, that's a rider. Yeah. Dude, when I ran my motorcycle,
17,000 miles on my Audi in the last 2 months.
I can tell you right now, like I had customers that literally would come in every year and get their oil changed every year. And they would have like 500 miles on the bike from the time I did the oil change before.
Oh yeah, I'll do three oil changes this year on my motor.
Yeah, yeah, that's good, still man. Stupid. If you ever tried it, you're either gonna love it or you're gonna hate it.
No, I won't ever try it. So we're gonna be
me
good.
And the guys that I ride with. We're gonna put together a ride next year probably where we're just gonna nowhere ride. We don't have any specific place to be. We're gonna take a week. We're gonna put.
How can you do that?
The best ever.
I could not function. There is no way in hell I could be involved in a let's all get together and not have a plan event. Like,
so we're gonna get.
I would lose my mind.
We'll throw tents on the back of the bike, hit the road, and be like, you look at the weather and go, all right, it's not raining this way. Let's head that way.
Yep.
You find you a campground, spend the night, wake up next morning, and do the same thing.
Yep.
But I also have been talking about. See, I've never been to Sturgis.
Haven't?
No. Been to all the East Coast ones, but never been to Sturgis. The couple times, like, the dealership, they would go to Sturgis, but they'd have – we had a customer that was on the truck line, and he would come by and pick all the bikes up, haul them to Sturgis, and then everybody fly out, get the bikes off the truck, and ride. But I want to actually ride out from the East Coast to Sturgis. But that's going to have to be, like, a two-week deal.
Oh yeah,
you're gonna have to find a better employer because I just marked down 3 weeks of vacation for you and your motorcycle crew. I don't think
Here's what we might can do is I can ride out to Iowa, and then work you know, I don't think it probably take me 3 days to get that. Well, I don't know. I'd have to look at it. Look at it. Yeah.
3 days? It's like 16 hours. Ride that shit. I can drive straight to, I can be at your house tomorrow afternoon.
There's a difference on a motorcycle, too, though.
Yeah, because you're so free, you have to stop. I'm so free, I'm required to stop and stay someplace.
No, not stay someplace, but you got to stop and get gas.
Well, and this, we should probably wrap up the most hated segment ever for Andy Reichert.
I don't know. The most
hated segment ever.
He hated hockey pretty good, too.
Yeah. This is better than hockey. For real.
Oh,
maybe.
So, speaking of sports, did you see where NC State got disqualified from the NCAA World Series this week because of COVID?
No.
Yeah, they had some COVID positive
That's
players.
That's the Wolfpack.
So, mm-hmm. So the NCAA disqualified them.
Well, that.
Yeah.
Well, that is what it is.
Now this is the most.
We ain't got time to talk about COVID bullshit. We got 10 minutes to talk about racing, and then go to bed.
We got plenty of time to talk about racing. She can cut whatever she wants to cut.
Well, she could cut the entire Harley section. is your dog still eating?
No, she's rolling around in the middle of the damn floor. Like, so Elizabeth's service dog is a golden retriever, and for some reason, her favorite thing to do is to lay down in the floor. Make this grunting noise that you may hear in the back and like kick their feet all over the place. And
she's scratching her back
on the floor, smiling like, I mean,
yeah. She's scratching her back. I can hear her.
Is there a dead fish on the floor that she likes to roll in?
No, no, you would think, but no.
Nope. So, anything interesting about racing that we need to talk about? I feel like this was a racing podcast. I feel like once every couple weeks it's a racing podcast and it's not. I'm going to a race next week.
So, here's the thing with this whole, is this a racing podcast, is it not? Though, what was the whole intent of this podcast? Us to get up here and just talk and talk about what we want to talk about. But you tried to get it too structured.
Well, I feel like the 13 people that listen may listen for a reason, and if we just keep changing gears on them, we may manage to be the first podcast ever recorded that nobody f***ing listens to. Ooh, earmuffs, yeah. Madison.
No, I'm telling you. My brother-in-law said it was the greatest thing he had. My brother-in-law said it was the greatest thing he had heard, and he didn't know how long.
Did he download it?
No, he was. Why would he download it? He was listening to it live. He was live studio audience.
Find out if he downloads it this week.
Yeah, I'll make sure he does. He'll get it.
No, I like. I'm up for whatever. I just feel like maybe people that listen for racing want to hear racing.
Oh yeah, maybe I mean, people I'm not that saying that we're not going to talk about racing.
But. Amanda claims we're not that entertaining. Sometimes, most of the time, we are. Sometimes,
I mean, you can't be gold all the time.
No, yeah. I don't know. Can you be Andy? Can we be gold all the time?
We can. I mean, there was some good stuff here. I mean, I think we covered a lot of exciting things. I mean,
yeah, if we made it a 10-minute highlight podcast, we'd be killing it.
Well, that's the thing.
Jumping it for the 10 seconds of highlights of our.
It's just like if you notice, it's just like TikTok now. They'll start the videos, and then it's like wait till the end, and then nothing happens at the end because you get more. You know, you get more algorithms or whatever.
Amanda, if you're listening to this, I want a beer poster. Like, I can't go find a young 22-year-old girl to give me a beer poster. So, like, maybe my wife can do a beer poster for me. She said no. I've asked, but I'm going to keep asking. Otherwise, we should make some beer posters. Like, just like the – we need to come up with a way to
do
like –
should have gone to bed beer poster.
No, we need to do, like, the dad bod beer poster thing. Like, just –
So this is what we need to do.
Hey, listen, nobody wants to see me on a beer poster.
I disagree. I think that's what people want.
I don't think nobody wants to see me right now on a beer poster without being fully clothed.
We better talk about our weight loss thing, too. I started today. It's on.
It's on.
Like,
we've got to make that official on this podcast because I'm starting.
To hold us accountable. Yes. But if we were to come out in like the greatest dad bod dad outfits, like the white socks up to the ankles and either white New Balances or sandals.
Oh yeah.
Like the, you know, you could do the I'm the Grill Master t-shirt or the Or the flower shirt, the Hawaiian shirt or whatever.
Like this, and, dog? Come
yeah,
on.
You know, I think if we were to come out with that, we all get our significant others. Yeah, we get our significant others to take pictures of us, and then we send it in and get Ryan to come up with a beer poster.
Dude, we can do the beer posters as an app for it.
Is it an app for it? I don't know.
I think so.
Yeah.
You know, we can do it. I never see what they're on those certain TikToks. They're going, watch it again. Did you see it? Watch it again. Did you see it? And I'm like, I never see it. So I just
that's a trick. On. That's just a trick. Come on, yeah, I know. To get you to watch
I got
it over
that
and over
like 100 times.
I hate it when they tell you to slow it down or to, you know, watch it in. Whenever they say that, I automatically.
Yeah, but some of those, so a lot of times it's somebody that'll do something and they have like a hidden picture in there or something that they do to avoid TikTok from catching it and pulling it down.
Oh, okay.
So if you save the video, like if you click on it and save it.
Too many steps.
Yeah.
Me watching the reason I watch TikToks is to sit on the toilet and just go, huh, that's funny, huh, that's funny, not download.
You click save video and then you pull it up and you scroll through it.
See, ever since my algorithm started showing me some stuff that I didn't want to see, I figured out there's a button there that says not interested. So I've been spamming that button. Not interested. Now my feed has been updated with guns and motorcycles.
The other day in the office, Andy's like, "This TikTok thing y'all got me going." He's like, it's like, how does it determine what it shows you?" I'm like, "Why? What you been doing?" He's like, "Man, basically every video I see is like transgender." I'm like. That's some funny shit right there. I don't know what you've been watching, but there's a reason for it. But
yeah, it was just Pride
Week. No, there's not.
Pride Week or Pride Month or whatever.
Yeah, it's Pride Month ending. My favorite is the ones where it's like the music that, like, I guess the girls are shaking their ass to, dancing to, and all that kind of stuff. They use the music, but they do it on food or how to like cook a steak or something like that. And like, so I like doing that, and then, you know, which Molly doesn't watch the TikTok, so half the time she don't know what any of it is. But I'll be watching something, and the girls are like, "Daddy, what are you watching?" And I'm like, "What? That's you're watching a girl shake her ass." I'm like, "Nope." And I'll turn around and be like a guy cooking a steak or something.
Yeah, there's some good ones out there.
TikTok is fun. I was not a fan of TikTok before we got into the whole race.
I remember when I convinced you to get a TikTok.
Yeah, yeah.
And I probably shouldn't have. You'd probably have made me a millionaire by now.
Yeah, because what I do is sit around all day on TikTok.
That's what I do. Everybody in this office thinks that I'm down here working. I'm just down here TikToking it all day.
Nine times out of ten, I TikTok on the toilet and then when I'm in a car going down the road, which is probably not the safest thing.
Think of the old days where people had to read magazines when they were on the jitter. Like, how annoying would that be? You know, it's like nothing. Andy, what are you watching TikTok?
Well, I was trying to like prove that my feed had been cleaned up, but then failed.
Do you ever get that noted? Like when you're driving, you're just like, dude, I should just pull over and watch TikTok for like 15 minutes. Like, I just need a break.
Look, so have you ever been in the bathroom and like before you had the phones and all this kind of thing, you didn't have nothing to read and you grab a shampoo bottle and just start reading the back of it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Read the shampoo bottle, read deodorant.
Whatever.
Like, the weirdest thing about every shower product is they're like 92% water. I'm like, what the?
Yeah.
Like, you know, but yeah, I'm the same way. I look for anything to read.
It's like alcohol. Alcohol is like 96% water.
Yeah. Yeah.
So. And now when you're on the toilet, your legs fall asleep because you have to.
You have been waiting too long.
Yep.
I always get this. Are you done yet? Are you in there shitting or are you watching TikTok?
Yeah.
Both.
Yeah. Well, I was shitting. Now I'm watching TikTok.
Yeah.
It's the way it should be.
Yeah. So, no, I didn't watch the race at all Saturday. Did you watch the race Saturday? It was a doubleheader at Pocono.
I watched Saturday. Yeah, I watched the Xfinity Series race. And then, no, Xfinity was on Sunday. So, on Saturday, I watched... I watched some of the race.
Yeah, because I
watched about 10 minutes of the race, and then I slept for 3 hours, and I woke up on literally woke up on the last lap and was like, ooh, shocking. Kyle Larson wins another race, and then in the last corner, he blew a tire and put it into the wall, and I'm like, whoa, yeah. So happy I was awake for that.
Yeah. Yeah, so we stopped at Buffalo Wild Wings, of course, and I'm in there, and they got the TVs up and watching it, and I'm like, oh, yeah, here you go. And I sent you a text. I was like, Kyle Larson does it again.
That's and probably you, why I woke up, now that I think about it.
And about time I hit the send button, I saw him, like, you could see, like, you saw the front of the car go. And he started dragging the skirt, and I was like, what the? Right to the wall. I was like, oh, I just jinxed that bastard bad.
Yeah.
But, yes, but, it, I mean, it, I don't know if it was a good race before then. Again, I didn't watch
I didn't see a whole lot of it. I imagine it was probably dominated by Kyle Busch or Kyle Larson.
The Hendricks cars were running pretty solid. So the Xfinity race, I enjoyed the Xfinity race. I think it was a decent race. I mean, it wasn't a big, you know, it was a couple times guys running guys down and some close racing and stuff like that. I mean, it wasn't a fabulous race by any means, but it was a decent race.
It was good. I mean, we were up and down. We ran, we passed a lot of cars, and once again had an issue where somehow, some way, we ran out of fuel.
Twice.
Twice, yeah.
Yeah.
We ran out of fuel, and then we came back around, put fuel in, went out, ran two laps, and ran out of fuel again.
Yeah.
So I still don't know.
I'm thinking it had to be like they didn't get fuel in it. That because
one of the two is something, who knows?
Yeah, I mean, because he didn't hit, like, when he went in, I mean, that was a long stint they ran before he went in, because they came in on lap 70.
We ran a potload of laps before we pitted, and then we ran out of fuel after we pitted.
Yeah, so because, you know, they said, what I think what they was said was either it was the pickup or didn't get fuel in. If it was the pickup, I would have thought he would have already kind of been at that point where he would have been. I'm thinking something was going on with the actual fuel delivery, whether it be the two.
Yeah, but wouldn't you, or, like, so, I mean, now granted, I'm not a gas man because you got to be like 6'5 to do that or something, or 6'4 or something. But, like, here's the deal. What do those weigh? Like 85, 90 pounds?
So it's 8 pounds per gallon. It's 10 gallons of fuel. And then the can itself weighs like 4 pounds, 5 pounds.
Okay. So anybody who wants to put that math together, I said probably 85, 90 pounds. Ray broke it down to get to 85, 90 pounds.
I'm just giving the information, Mike. Right. I want people to know why it weighs 85 pounds. Or
the can weighs 4 pounds. The gas inside the can weighs 80 pounds, right?
Yeah.
So when you put it in and the gas goes out of it, you would think you'd notice it gets lighter. Now, I'm not saying they did or didn't. This is all just assumption. But, like, if you're putting 10 gallons of fuel in and the can weighs the same, you would think that was my only thing behind it is how would the guy not know that there's not gas going into it? I don't know any of our
crew. I agree. Most of the time, especially in those fuel mileage deals like that, they'll actually weigh the can and tell you how much went in, you know.
Yeah.
And this may be a silly question, but there's no gas gauge in a car?
No.
No.
Mm-mm. Okay. It's a fuel cell. So, I mean, the electronics of these cars are so minuscule, they take everything away they can because, of course, the more amps you had to produce by the alternator, the less horsepower you're taking horsepower away from the motor. So they don't need one, right? You wouldn't think it'd be probably be nice to have, but at the same time, you got a car that's going, you know,
leaning
so much and back stuff. So you're sitting there, it would be doing. Imagine, like, you know, the fuel gauge on a boat, right? I mean, it just sits there.
Yeah.
I mean, how accurate is that? You know. So, and I don't know. This is something that I'd like to know. I know, like, on the cup cars, they actually have a box in the corner of the tank that once it gets to a certain level, like the fuel, it fills up when they fill the car up, of course, but it doesn't, it stays the same level the entire race. So it'll still have like a gallon or a gallon and a half of gas in it when the tank's totally empty, and they can flip a switch and it's an auxiliary pump. So when the cup cars, like you heard them yesterday, like I think it was Kyle was coming after he took, I think going into one or two, he's like, she stumbled, and they said, flip the switch. Well, he flipped the switch, and he had enough gas to get back around and win the race, which I don't think the Xfinity cars have those, because that would have been the first thing I would have thought about when you're running out of gas is flip the switch. But, again, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. Huh. But yeah, so I probably should have called to find out exactly what happened, but spilled milk. Yeah, I mean, it's just another situation where honestly,
is spilled milk the same thing as spilled milk?
Oh fuck, here we go with this shit again.
I just want to know. I'm asking for a friend.
But no, so Kyle, I mean, you know, probably should have been a top 20 run for sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, speed was there.
Yeah,
car was good, passed a lot of people, and once again, you know. Something happens.
I mean, I think it really would have really been probably a 17th, 18th place finish. I mean, just the way he was running and the car.
Same car too. Around.
Yeah,
same car we've run like the last four times. That car just every time car. Runs they, good they, and then has an issue.
They've done some extra stuff going to the pull down, figure some stuff out. I mean, you know, they're doing some stuff that make them better. Now it's just I'm not gonna call. I don't know if that's luck, bad luck, or whatever.
No.
I mean, because we had stops before where they got fuel and had no issue.
Yeah.
Right. So, you know, I don't know if it, you know, a valve was stuck in that thing or whatever, but it was a rough day.
What it is.
Ended up finished 26, still hanging out 35th.
I think 27th.
I'm pretty sure it was.
Yeah, because we dropped to 36 in owner points.
Yeah, still hanging. Oh, we did drop? I thought we hung in 35th.
36th.
Okay.
JD Power Sports went ahead. We're ahead of, but that's in owner points, which nobody on the podcast cares about. Driver points.
Number 47 finished 26th.
Yeah, 26.
He did?
Yeah.
Well, then the NASCAR app was wrong.
That's not anything new.
Yeah, that's typical.
Yeah, other than the scanner, I don't even hardly pay attention to it anymore. It's like, anyway.
Well, yeah, they do show him 26 now.
Yeah.
Good.
But, that was a decent race. Cindric, I thought Ty Gibbs was going to run Cindric down.
If he had another lap,
he would have got him.
Yeah, I think he would have got him for sure.
Yeah.
And then Cup race. Then I went and played golf, so I didn't get to watch Cup race, but Kyle won, which I'm
I watched bits and pieces of it. It was pretty much follow the leader race the whole day. Come down to be a fuel mileage deal. And so Kyle had issues with his transmission. It was popping out of
Bush
gear.
Or Larson.
Yeah, Bush.
Or Weatherman. Was
Bush. This was a Cup ride. Bush.
Okay.
So he was having problems with his transmission. So what won him the race was he had to come in another lap. He came in, got tires, got fuel, come out, transmission kept popping out. He came back in. They hit him with fuel again while they were basically putting the car in fourth gear and making it stay in fourth gear. So he ended up having that extra lap of fuel because he had to come back in. That's what won him the race. But I will say Kyle Larson, right? Kyle Larson started in 30th because he had to go to a backup. So he had to start in the – or no, I'm sorry. He had to start in the back, the way back. Started in the back. Ended up got into a wreck, not like a big wreck, but damaged the nose of the car and all this kind of stuff. And at the end of that race, if he had had another lap, he would have caught Kyle Busch.
Speaking of, now that we say that, we didn't even talk about Kyle and the wreck he avoided with Justin
Weatherman.
That was like the best thing. Madison, you've got to play that clip. I'm sure you can find it. Amanda has it from Tiki Taki and all that stuff. But, I mean – my favorite part of that, though, is Kyle, who are Kyle. So going back into Kyle Weatherman, he's pretty reserved, pretty quiet. You don't hear him swearing a lot. But on the radio, he most certainly let loose on that. I mean, Andy, you'll have to see. We'll show you the replay of this tomorrow. But, like, a car came across the front, and at the last second, he just snapped it to the left. And, I mean, there can't be 2-3 inches between the two cars. Man. I mean, it's just, and you know, you're traveling at 170, 180 mile an hour at that point.
Because that was coming onto the long pond. That was coming onto the long pond. Not only did he snap it to the left to miss a car, he snapped it to the left and that bastard got sideways.
Oh, yeah.
And then he brought it back.
He saved it and then drove it down and left with it. It was quite impressive. And then there was a lot of jokes about changing your underwear and stuff like that that went on afterwards.
Yeah.
But it was really impressive driving. Like, I don't know how he missed that, but Madison has the clip because I know we replayed it a couple times so Amanda could record some stuff with it, and it was crazy. It was close.
Yeah.
So there's something about being in the 47 in the axe car.
Axe car. Yeah, because at Daytona, he's the same thing. Yeah. So when he missed that car, he was like, oh, he's like, there's no way I didn't hit him. There's no way I didn't hit him. There's no way you couldn't have fit a sheet of paper between the two cars. Holy shit. And again, Kyle don't cut. Holy shit. It was crazy.
He's in there going like, that was so much closer than Daytona. It was close. No doubt about it,
And then the broadcasters didn't know who was driving the 47 car. I'm like, come on.
Well, they called it the 74, and what an impressive move it was for Jesse Ouija to miss him. And I'm like, it's the 47, not the 74.
I need to check and see if Junior's dyslexic or not.
Yeah, no. Yeah. He had to make sure he got his 74 plug in at the end of the race anyway. So.
Yeah.
And this weekend we're off to Road America. So I'm actually going to run up there before 4th of July on the 3rd. And we got to qualify for Road America. But I'm
going
to go.
You going up with him, Molnax?
He's checked out. He's reading stuff.
Is he reading stuff or is he?
Yeah, he's checked out.
No, I didn't hear it.
Man, I'm thinking you'd replay that face. My camera locked up.
Yeah, that's what happened. My camera locked up.
He's like, you mean me? No, Bobby's going up with me on the axe car. I'm meeting him up, and then we're gonna run over there quick, and
cool.
Then we're gonna run back on Saturday.
Yeah. So here you go. This is it right here, Monax. Can you see that?
Yep.
All right.
Oh, this is our TikTok?
Yeah.
The car swerving is us.
This is the 47.
Whoa.
Yeah. And then then Vargas creamed Haley.
Yeah.
That was a hard hit. That was a hard hit. But yeah.
Madison. Here, that was the slow-mo.
Oh, I forgot the slow-mo. Let me go back.
No, that's fine. Madison can replay it.
Hold on.
I just like having your computer up so I can see what's going on with your ads. I like to know what you're shopping for.
Oh, yeah, this is a much better.
Yeah, watch this. And right
there.
Ooh.
Wow.
Yeah, that's close.
Yeah. Yeah. That was close.
Yeah, that's pretty darn close.
Yeah.
Which was good.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so I'm going to go out and watch race this weekend. From the pits, I'm not going to the cup race because, well, it's 4th of July and I want to be home. Who are you talking to, Ray?
Molly. She wants to know if I'm in the kitchen now. Like, everywhere. So the complaint used to be I was in the bedroom. She can't go to sleep. Now I'm in the kitchen and she can't go.
Molly, you can just come in and be on the podcast.
That's what I told her. Come in. Join the podcast, Molly. She's like, no part of it.
Tell her we're wrapping up anyway. We're just working our way to our closing.
Yeah, she'll be all right.
Tell her you'll make yourself a dang quesadilla.
Make yourself a quesadilla.
Oh yeah, we got to talk about weight loss because I'm about to. Gonna lose weight here, we got to be held accountable. So I weighed I weighed in, and I was at 213.6, which is huge for me again. So I'm announcing that, and I'm going back down to. I want to get down to 185 again. So I'm gonna go lose
my leg weighs.
What? 185 or 213? I don't know. It's up to y'all. I'm just saying I'm doing this to hold myself accountable because I could go home and eat like all that candy that I just bought for my kids, and I'm not going to. I'm done. I'm so tired of feeling like crap.
Yeah, I weighed last night, and I'm at 243. That's the biggest I've ever been. Like, the biggest I've ever been was 240, and I was 243. Now, I don't eat – like, typically, even when I'm not doing my – fasting, I don't eat breakfast. I'm just not a breakfast person. I usually don't eat breakfast. Lunch, like, I typically would, but I also don't drink a lot of sodas and sweet teas and stuff like that, right? But this past week, I got up every morning and I cooked breakfast, so I ate. Of course, then I was drinking Pepsis, drinking sweet teas, eating all the candies at all the theme parks, and kolaches from Bucky's, and burritos from Bucky's and tacos from Bucky's and nuts from Bucky's and, you know, all
the problem is if
Bucky's.
It's convenient and tasty, it's bad.
Yeah. So, So I've got to get, And like, I can tell.
Dollar
like,
egg rolls from Quickstar.
Dude, I'm going to miss those the most.
What are they?
Gas station egg rolls, man.
Oh,
Quickstar makes really good egg rolls.
So we were at Magic Kingdom, and we walked by this thing, and they had buffalo chicken spring rolls and cheeseburger spring rolls.
Oh.
And it was like
we can't talk about food if we're going
to. I know. We had just got into the park, so like me and my sister-in-law, we were like, oh, yeah, we're coming back and getting some of those. And then, of course, we go and do the rest of the park and stuff, and we're getting ready to head out. And both of us like, all right, let's run by and get our spring rolls. Well, of course, that cart had closed down by this time, so I never got my buffalo chicken spring roll, which I was pretty upset about.
I got to go feed my pond. That's how I'm going to stop talking about food. Looks like a little bag of cocaine here. It's not, I don't think. For sure it's not.
Well, anyway. Yeah. I never liked cocaine. I just like the smell of it.
That's exactly right. That's a brilliant. I don't even like cocaine. It just smells really good.
It just smells good. So we'll go, like, I don't know. Some of these kids these days. We go to a lot of chopper campouts, right? So instead of going to the big rallies, like, I'm over those. I've done all those. That's not a big deal. So what we'll do is there's Twin Rivers camp out. There's back Road Barbecue Run camp out, War Run camp out. So it's just you ride to this area, you camp out, and you get up the next day and you ride all over the mountains or you ride all over the beach or whatever. So I showed up one time to this camp out. And I'm helping the guys set up or whatever. I had to go to Charlotte. All my guys were coming up after me. I had to go up to Charlotte for something else. So I rode up to Charlotte and then rode over. So I'm helping them out. And the guy's like, so we finished it and set up and sitting at the table drinking a beer with the guy. He's like, hey, man, appreciate the help. Da, da, da. Super, super nice. Guy goes, so he's like, man, all the help you gave us today, man, anything you need this weekend, I got you. I was like, yeah, I'm good. Whatever. He's like, man, what you into? I was like, just drinking and having a good time, bud. You know, he's like, man, I got shrooms, I got coke. I'm like, what the fuck? Where am I at? Am I back in the 70s or what? I was like, no, man, I'm good. I appreciate it. Y'all have a good time.
He took off his leather jacket.
It was ridiculous, like, man.
Powers tie-dye shit.
Yeah. Like, I'd always heard, like, walking into the bathroom and, like, there's just powdery residue on the back of the toilet where they were huffing. Letterkenny talks about it. Huffing the sneeze or huffing
sneeze. Oh, yeah. I don't even know what that was all about. So I don't.
Yeah. But anyway, but
a lot of the drug stuff goes over me. It sucks.
Yeah. It sucks. Yeah. But I was like, I just
don't know the cool lingo of.
Yeah. So we moved our campground away from those guys. It was like, the last thing I want to do be like sleeping the night, and all of a sudden you see blue lights and red lights coming in. They just swoop up the whole crowd. But it's good times, man.
Good.
Yeah.
So. Anything else? I don't have any big dramatic endings for tonight.
Not really. I mean, nothing. I mean, like I said, the cup race was pretty anticlimactic. Oh, did you see this confirmed picks. Now?
Road America, first ever Road America for cup, right?
Yes, for cup, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Xfinity was there last year. Did you see Keselowski has been confirmed going to Roush Fenway next year?
I did not see it was confirmed, I figured that's I would love to work with Roush Fenway because Keselowski's they will be a top team inside of 3 years. They'll probably be a top team next year, but with everybody going to the new car.
Yeah.
But within 3 years, it's on.
Yeah, so that's pretty interesting. It's going to be really interesting. And then, so the silly season starts now, right? Okay, so who goes into the two car? You know,
Cindric.
Well, Cindric was already signed to be in the 21.
Yeah, but they're not going to move Matty D in front of Cedric over to a Penske car. Matty D's not a Penske car.
But guess what? It depends on what you got to realize. Sponsor contracts. Right,
yeah.
The Wood Brothers sponsor contracts. If they got sponsor contracts that says Austin Cindric's the driver, guess what?
Yeah, Penske probably can be like, boo-hoo, find another alliance.
If you got a contract, I mean, without
Yeah, but if that contract's shit. With Wood Brothers, it ain't going to be a contract that has anything to do with Penske.
But if you as we are sponsors, right,
yeah.
We've got a contract that says Kyle Weatherman drives the number 47 Wolfpack car, right? Now, all of a sudden, they want to change that.
Correct.
How are you going to feel?
The reality of it is that if the team wanted to do that, they could. They wouldn't get my money, but they could do it.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. I don't know that they necessarily not put Cindric in the 21.
You think they're going to put Matty D in the 2 car?
I don't know, man. I don't see
Matty D
I
mean, one fan favorite. He ain't going nowhere.
Matty D's the only one that doesn't have a contract for next year.
Yeah, because he wasn't going nowhere.
And Ryan Newman doesn't have one either. And Fenway, Roush Fenway.
So Cedric can go to the two.
So is so that yeah, that's right. Because Lasky will go to the six. Buescher will stay in the 17. I think he's got a 3-year deal, right?
Yeah, something. Yeah. Yeah. Cedric will go to the two. Matty D will stay in the 21.
You think?
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see.
It's going to be a less of a silly season. You think? There's going to be some moves, but and then you know the interesting thing is going to be with all the college stuff and things like that. There's going to be some different changes coming in, but
yeah.
All in all, it's way too early to be predicting all that.
Oh yeah, but it's
that's what makes it fun.
Well, they're already talking about too, because you know with the college buying those two charters from Spire, one of those charters is the charter that Trackhouse is running this year.
Yeah.
So.
Well, and I heard B.J. McLeod turned down over $10 million for his charter.
Really?
Seven figures.
Holy hell. Which, I mean,
or eight figures, I mean. Eight figures. I don't know. It was. I don't know what it was. It was over $10
million. Yeah. I think that most of them have been going for like $4 to $6 million bucks.
Not anymore.
Up to recently. But they're going, I mean, the
yeah, part, they're
the
like, stocks because I think that, I don't know, but I think Colleague gave close to 10 or over 10 for those.
So you know who made out like a bandit is Spire.
What?
You know who made out like a bandit is Spire.
For sure.
Oh, my God.
You know who else is going to make out like a bandit?
Rick Ware.
Hell, yes. Rick Ware is sitting in a room right now counting his money, going, all these people that talk shit about me on their podcast because my cars don't win are all going to get a birthday card that says, eat my shit.
Yeah.
When I cash these checks for $20 million.
Yeah.
Like, that's it. That's what I'd do. Rick
Ware's just sitting there.
And I'd fly over their house on weekends.
Just Rick Ware's sitting there going, oh, yeah, Pitbull, you need a charter?
Mm-hmm. Because you know that guy can't write the check, right?
Justin Marks and Pitbull need a charter?
Yeah. Denny Hamlin and Michael Jordan want another charter?
Yeah.
Let's see. BJ McLeod ain't going to sell. Yeah. So, yeah. There's a lot of money going into that.
Oh, yeah. A huge amount. Anyway,
but that'll be more coming up with Silly Season soon. But next week's 4th of July, so.
Huge.
Well, before we wrap up, so for the 13 people that are listening, head on over to YouTube or make a comment on the most embarrassing thing that ever happened to you in public. And so let's see if we get some comments on that.
Right to the end. We'll have to do a Facebook post of that. What is it?
The most embarrassing thing that ever happened to you in public.
Ooh. Yeah, we can talk about that next week. I don't know if I've ever done anything embarrassing in public.
No.
I don't know what it would be.
I busted my ass on going up to Space Mountain the other day, but it was the only people that saw me was my family, so that don't count.
What was in public? All right. Yeah. Well, Andy, better write that down so you can have Sadie do a post because we'll get some comments out of posts. I don't know if anybody listens to this all the way through.
Yeah, they do. Everybody does. All the thousands listening at home.
What we'll start doing is just being like, hey, if you're still listening, send us a message with this code and we'll give you $5. We'll start buying our shit. Like, who cares?
We'll send you some string cheese.
Yeah, because Madison's going to be like, hey, I just sent you a message with a code. Damn it. She's getting another raise.
She's the only one. Every week. She's the only one.
But she said she listens to this where we sound like chipmunks because she puts it in like.
For XP. That's why she misses the F bombs. So she can listen to us in like 15 minutes.
Because she wants it under an hour, and we're at an hour, like around an hour. We're at an hour 23.
I've accidentally done that before, like, I guess hit it in my pocket or whatever, and it, like, speed up, and I'm like, what the hell? Why does it, you know, it's crazy. I can't
do on the podcast, when you're listening to people, I'm like.
I can't do it.
All right, boys, enjoy the rest of your evening. I say we wrap this bitch.
Sounds good, man. All right, bye.
See you guys.
See ya.